Today's program, Unfinished Romantic. Each of the pieces has some quality or other of being unfinished. Don't worry, we're not going to drift off in the middle of everything and just stop. Schubert wrote two movements of his 8th symphony, and in my opinion, they are the best two symphonic movements he ever composed. It's unfortunate he did not have the time to go back and finish, but it is a staggering piece of music, and it is absolutely worth being performed, even if it wasn't complete. But the rest of the program, first, Fanny Mendelssohn. All the notes were there, don't worry. But this is more representative of a career cut short. In that particular time, sort of polite Victorian society, women were not really welcome in the concert hall. Good thing is that Fanny Mendelssohn did get to conduct this once. It wouldn't have been at a major type concert. It was more at a society type function where they didn't have as many issues with that. So she did get to conduct it once, but imagine if she had conducted it, say, 30 times, and had started formulating some, you know, ideas, maybe even sort of writing into the scores and performance practice. And then what if it had been published, so she had come up with a final version? It was never published in her lifetime. So for us to be able to take this piece and bring it to you and finish up the details and make sure we're speaking with a coherent voice, I think we're going to make a good statement for this and also for her music. But it's a shame that when you hear how great this overture is, it's a shame that we don't have a large output from her in the repertoire, because she was an amazing composer. Then we, on the second half, Beethoven's Leonore Overture number 1. In a way, it's kind of reassuring to think that you have Ludwig von Beethoven, the most amazing composer of his time, showing self-doubt. He wanted to compose a great opera. It started its life as Leonora, but he wasn't happy yet. He didn't think it was good enough. And so he began refining and refining and refining until the final product, Fidelio. And he wrote no fewer than 4 overtures for this. This is Leonore Overture number 1. Don't worry, all the notes are there. But amazing to think that he could write an entire overture, and instead of just modifying, changing, he says, nope, not good enough. That's it. They just tossed it out. Amazing. And then finally, César Franck's Symphonic Variations. Again, all the notes are there. The issue for me is really César Franck. He was quite popular. His Symphony in D minor was quite popular in the 60s and 70s. There's some wonderful recordings back then. For some reason, it doesn't get played as much today. I don't understand why. And the Symphonic Variations is also everything that we would want from a romantic piano concerto. Soaring melodies, the pianist is sort of the hero of the piece, gorgeous sounds from the orchestra. But for some reason, Franck fell out of favor, and it's really too bad. So I think when you hear this, not only will you be glad to hear it, but you'll say at the end, well, gosh, there's plenty of room in my heart and in my mind for César Franck. Sure, we could have him as part of the party. So we're going to have something of an adventure today, and I thank all of you for braving the weather out there and being here for it, and I hope you enjoy the program. Thank you.